guys, and welcome back to my channel. This video is going to be the Wizard of Panning finale. This is a Fantastic Ladies collab, so as always I will link the creator and the Fantastic Ladies Facebook group in the description box down below. This project kind of has been interesting. I really enjoyed doing it. I picked some really great items and I hit goal on a bunch of those items. The items that were left, as you know from the previous update, which was only a few weeks ago, but I'm still trying to catch up on getting this up on time so that the finale is done before the end of December, which is when the project finishes. So anyway, you know from that video that there were some items that were lingering and we were gonna try and see what we could do with them. So this is me coming on and saying that I did what I could with some of them. Some of them repeat offenders, again, I did not touch. Probably you are not surprised. So, the first one was for Dorothy, and that was something that I thought would be easy to pan but wasn't, and I picked this shadow here. This is the Inglot shadow number 33. I can tell you that now because I took these out of the Inglot palette because the Inglot palette was doing my head in. The gouge marks have been in it since the beginning of the project, so you can ignore those, but I did not touch this eyeshadow the entire project. So that is the first item. So the next item was something deceiving, and for that I picked a colour changing lipstick, which, how have I lost it? It's here. Which was the Hufflepuff colour changing lipstick that looks yellow but changes to a pink shade to the pH balance of your skin. And to be honest, I lost this and I explained last time that I lost it, so there's no progress since the line that I drew there. So that is where we are finishing. The next item was for the Scarecrow. No, the next item was for the Tin Man. That was finished. The next one was Something You Are Scared to Pan for the Scarecrow. And for that I picked this loose pigment, Mr. Toad's Wild Ride by Notoriously Morbid. Didn't touch this. You'll probably find that as a big surprise. Not. But yes, I didn't touch this the entire project and I still haven't touched it. So that is that one. The next one was Something Out of Your Comfort Zone for the Cowardly Lion. And for that I picked the Sleek Blush. And I picked this shade in the middle here, and this one I did get progress on, but as we all know, blushes are really hard to hit pan on, so that is the progress for that one. And the next one was for Glinda, and that was Something Glittery, and for that I picked this. This is the Makeup Revolution Pressed Glitter Palette. I can't remember what this particular palette was called, but I wanted to pick this shade here, Fierce, and I did not touch it the entire project because, as I've explained many times, I've not used glitter this year because what is the point in wearing glitter if you're not leaving the house. The next one was for the Wicked Witch of the West, and there was Something You Don't Like, Something That You Hate, and that was nail polish. I finished that up. Toto was Something You Love, and I finished that up. I picked a body spray. Munchkins was Something To Protect Your Skin, and for that I picked an SPF. That went in the bin. Then I got this SPF and I stopped using it because I wasn't leaving the house. So I did get some progress on it, and it was starting here and then moving to this line above it because it's a product that pushes upwards, but it was brand new when I rolled it in, so I wasn't expecting to get very far on it, especially seeing as none of us were leaving the house. I don't sit by the window, so I don't really need SPF on my skin when that's happening, so that is that. Lollipop Guild, that was something candy related, that was done. Monkeys was Something That Stalks You, that was the Wet n Wild Reserve Your Cabana, which I considered finished a long time ago, but I kept it in the project to see if I would use any more of it, and I didn't, so that is where we are finishing on that one. I wanted to hit pan as my original goal, so we did actually hit goal on that. A Horse of a Different Colour was Something Duochrome, and that was the Don't Desert Me eyeshadow. I hit pan on that. Auntie M was Something Comforting, and that was a body cream. I finished that up. Uncle Henry was Something That Brings Back Memories, and this hurts me. It pains me because this eyeshadow is probably one use, one even touch with a brush away from hitting pan, and I could not hit the pan. So that is where we are finishing. It pains me. It really does. I might put it in my first ever makeup basket just to hit the pan and then put it back in my drawer, but yeah, I'm upset. The next one was Yellow Brick Road, and that was Something Yellow, so I picked a Maybelline Baby Skin in the yellow packet. That one was finished. Emerald City was Something Green, and I don't know if you can tell because I kind of shook this up, but this is the Avon Gel Nail Polish in the shade P822, by the way, and we are finishing here, just there. So if I show you at the side, you might be able to see it a bit better. You see this line here? That is where we're finishing. So the next item was for Ruby slippers, and that was something red. And for that, I picked the NARS Dolce Vita lip pencil. It just looks like that. And we are at the last mark that I drew on the paper, just because I did not use this entire update. So that is where we are finishing there. And the last item was for poppies, and that was something you only use at night. And for that, I had a night cream, and it is this Vitamin E night cream, and this is where we're finishing on this one. This is another one that I didn't use this update, just because I've been really lax with my skincare again. So this one finished at 53 grams. Originally, it weighed 57 grams. So if I go ahead and add up all the items that I actually finished in this project, it was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8, I think? Let me count again. Yes, 8 items hit goal on or finished within this project. So 8 to me is amazing. That's probably the highest that I've ever had in one of these Pantastic Ladies collabs, to be honest. Because normally when I pan, I either do really well or I do really badly. Most of the time, really badly. So I'm really happy with the fact that I hit goal on 8 items in this project alone. Let me know how you got on with yours. I'd be really happy to hear, like, overall how many items you hit goal on. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Take care, and I will see you very soon. Bye!